So there were plenty of fascinating moves that were made last offseason, a good amount by the 49ers, as they made plenty of moves, but one of the more interesting ones was the 49ers signing Kwon Alexander to a big contract. At the time, it seemed like a bit of an overpay, which is why Tampa Bay let him walk, because he could get so much money for San Francisco, and a lot of people were kind of wondering, why pay so much for a guy who has proven that he can be inconsistent in certain areas? I mean, his statistics have always been great, and that includes an 145 tackle season, and in that season, he actually led the league in most solo tackles, because he had 108 of those. So anytime you're getting 100 plus solo tackles, that's definitely very impressive. But at the same time, what those stats don't show is all the missed tackles and all the times that he would maybe blow his coverage or just do a bad job in coverage, which would result in a tackle. However, so far, through 6 games for San Francisco, he's cleaned up a lot of his faults, and now he can really thrive. I mean, there's always been things that he's excelled at, and this play would be a good example of something that he's kind of always excelled at. This is what the San Francisco 49ers were looking for when they signed him, was so that he could make plays like this. It's going to be a run to the bottom half of the screen, and Alexander is a linebacker all the way on the top half of the screen, so you would think that this is going to be kind of a tough play for him to actually get into this play and try to make a tackle. So for Washington, they're not going to put a ton of effort onto him. They will have the left guard be the one who's going up to block Alexander, but again, Alexander's far away, this isn't the most difficult block in the world. But one interesting thing you're going to see, and it's a very heads-up thing that Kwon Alexander is going to do here, is watch what happens right when this ball is snapped. Watch how he just basically puts his right arm out like that. Essentially what he's doing right now is he already realizes this is the run to the bottom half of the screen. So now he just wants to make sure that that linebacker just isn't able to latch on to him. That's what you're trying to do here. Honestly, let's be real here, there's plenty of linebackers who would just take this play off and just sort of say, oh, okay, I'm getting blocked, somebody else make the play. I mean, there are guys that would do that, especially guys with a big contract, but that's just not in Alexander's DNA. Watch how he's going to use the arm to not allow that linebacker to create some good contact, and then he runs over and is able to actually make this tackle. Part of that is just having the speed to get over, but also just good handwork, and, you know, he was able to help make the tackle. They only gained a couple of yards when that play could have easily gone for more yards had he not been able to do that. That's what makes Alexander just so effective. That's the reason why San Francisco went out and paid him all his money, is because he's such a good east and west linebacker. There are absolutely better linebackers that are good at running up the middle and making tackles that way, but the way that he moves, I mean, it's almost like you have a safety but that can also play linebacker out there, just in terms of the way he moves laterally. In the running game, there's no doubt about it, he's such an effective player, and this one's another really good example of that, I think. Once again, it's going to be run to the bottom half of the screen, and Alexander is going to be actually closer to the bottom half of the screen this time. However, the Pittsburgh Steelers are doing something a little bit different than the Redskins did on that last play. Instead of just trying to send an offensive lineman straight up to block him, instead what they're going to do is pull their center over there, and he'll try to lead block for their halfback. That's what they're trying to do on this play. But what I want you to take a look at is look at Kwon and look at how quickly he's going to run over to the bottom half of the screen. I mean, it's practically instantaneous that he reads the play and then just bolts over to the bottom half of the screen. And if you look right now, I mean, he's beating Connor to the line of scrimmage, which is not easy to do. Now, there is a center who's going to be in the way to try to make this play, but at the same time, there's also another 49er player who read this play well and is trying to disrupt this play now. That's Arik Armstead, who, I mean, we all know what he can do. He's a pretty good player himself. So now, because of that, the Pittsburgh center can't really do a great job of getting over to try to block Kwon Alexander, and that frees Alexander up to potentially make this play, and since Alexander had the speed to get there so quickly, he is going to be able to run over and help make this play. And watch how, even though Connor makes a move, Alexander just gets his foot and is able to hold on long enough to make the tackle, and that actually goes for a tackle for a loss, which is not easy to do when you're a linebacker and it's a run to the sideline as opposed to just a run straight up the middle. So that's what we knew we were getting with Alexander. We knew he's a great east and west type of guy. We didn't really know that he could tackle that well. He's actually cleaned up his tackling quite a bit. Usually he was kind of not great at tackling, but for San Francisco, at least through 6 games, I do feel like his tackling has been much improved. And honestly, if Kwon Alexander can just be a solid tackler, he can be a fantastic player, just because he's so good at getting in position to make tackles. So yeah, I mean, San Francisco, they knew they were getting that with Alexander, but there were definitely some question marks. One of those was his tackling, which definitely has improved, but another one of those things was coverage. That was always kind of his weakness, is he relatively struggled in pass coverage. He was always a good run stopper, but playing in coverage, that's where he would struggle. However, he's been improving in that a lot as well. I mean, take a look at this play, for example. It's going to be a cover 2 zone, and for Cincinnati, they have a way that they feel confident they can beat this coverage, which is sending the receiver on the bottom half of the screen, simply just run a curl route, which should get into a gap in coverage. It's nothing too fancy, but this is a situation where, hey, you can attack Kwon Alexander, who's right there. You know he's not the best in coverage, so why not see if you can attack him and maybe get a first down here? And right after this ball snap, you will notice that there is some separation right here. Andy Dalton can try to make this throw. However, watch what Kwon Alexander is going to do. He's just going to leap up and knock this ball away. And again, that might not seem like the craziest play ever, but that's what he wasn't doing in Tampa Bay. And for San Francisco, they're good enough on defense. They don't need him to be an elite coverage linebacker. They just need him to be able to be competent in coverage. Because he's such a run stopper, as long as he's not a black hole in coverage, it can really be a huge benefit. And I also do feel like it has to help him that he's no longer with that terribly coached Tampa Bay defense of last year, and now he has an actual coach who has a brain and can actually help him. And there's also one more way that Alexander has really been able to thrive in the San Francisco defense, and that's because they have a good defensive line. So with that defensive line, it opens up plenty of doors for Kwon Alexander to do what he can do best, which is stop the run, and this play is a perfect example of that. Take a look at how it's going to work for Cincinnati. What they're going to do is have their right guard and right tackle double team Sheldon Day right there, but then the guard will get off the double team to move up to block Alexander. So okay, pretty simple play, nothing really too fancy here, but take a look at what Sheldon Day is going to do. Day is going to do a great job on this play. I think he read this play correctly, because watch how he just attacks that guard. Now if you're a Cincinnati guard, there's no way you can get off this double team. For Cincinnati, there's not really much you can do right here. I mean, maybe your tackle could try to get through and block Alexander, but that's tough to do, especially in such a split second. And now for Alexander, I mean, look at him. He looks like a lion ready to pounce, you know? He's just ready to try to run up and make this tackle, and he's kind of going to just let Joe Mixon run to him. He meets him at the line of scrimmage, able to make the tackle. They get no gain on that play. It was a good play by Alexander, but really it was set up by Sheldon Day. And that's kind of what the San Francisco 49ers team can do. They have so many guys on their line that can just set things up for their linebackers, Fred Warner and Kwon Alexander, who can both make good plays consistently. That's something that Kwon didn't have in Tampa Bay. He didn't have guys who made things easier on him. Here in San Francisco, these guys are making things easier on him, and so therefore he rewards them by getting tackles for no gain. I mean, a play like that is very different than what we saw when he was playing for the Bucks. You know, we would see situations where just plays would be disasters, and then he would be in cleanup duty trying to make tackles while running towards his own sideline as opposed to making tackles running forward. You would ideally like to have to make a tackle running forward as opposed to having to make a tackle with your shoulders turned. It's just an easier situation, especially for Kwon Alexander. He seems to be a lot better at making tackles running forward as opposed to if someone's by you and trying to make a tackle that way. And also, obviously, making a tackle forward is good because that usually means that you're not giving up many yards. One more play I love from Kwon, and this is just what you have to love about Kwon Alexander, is a play like this, where it's going to be a cover 3 zone that San Francisco is in, and for Cincinnati, they actually have a perfect way to try to beat this coverage. They're going to send two of their three receivers on the top half of the screen. They run those two routes right there. And so really, the idea is that the San Francisco player who's in charge of covering the zone, second closest to the top half of the screen, will then continue running up to make sure that he's covering up one of those Bengals. But since a third is cutting underneath him, he can potentially get open. That's the way this play is supposed to work on paper. And for Alexander, he's all the way on the bottom half of the screen. So you might be thinking, well, why am I showing this play? I mean, he has nothing to do with what the play is actually going to happen here. I mean, all the craziness is going on up top of the screen. He's all the way on the bottom half of the screen. He won't get into this play. And while it is true that just nobody would be able to run up and knock that ball away, I mean, even if you're the best player ever, you couldn't do that. So the play works out for Cincinnati, and now a receiver has the ball, but look at Alexander. Despite the fact that he's still 5 yards behind that receiver and way over on the other side of the field of that receiver, watch his hustle here. He's just going to run as quick as he can, tries to make a display, and is going to actually get into the play and help make that tackle. That's kind of a little thing. I mean, that's not something that you'll put on a highlight reel by any means, but those little things are what makes Kwon Alexander so effective, is the fact that he gives his all on every play. He definitely is one of those guys that, as the old cliche goes, he gives 110% every play. It's pretty crazy. A contract that a lot of us were kind of scratching our heads and saying, that seems a little bit high. Honestly, now Kwon Alexander looks like he might be underpaid. I mean, he looks like he's worth every penny for what he's brought to that San Francisco team. I actually rewatched my video about Kwon Alexander that I made right when the signing happened, and one thing I said is that I'm a Bucks fan, and I was very disappointed when Kwon Alexander left, so I said I definitely will be rooting for him in San Francisco. But honestly, I've been pleasantly surprised with how well he's played. I wish he was doing this for my team, but I'm still happy that he's just doing this in general. It looks like he's put it all together. I mean, it looks like he's fixed a lot of his weaknesses. One thing I still do have to mention is it seems like he's still overrunning players from time to time. That is kind of one of his problems, but Other than that, his tackling has gotten better, his coverage has gotten a lot better, and he's still just as good in the run game. And oh yeah, by the way, he's only 25, so this could actually end up being a great signing for John Lynch. It's working out very well for the San Francisco 49ers, and he has been a key reason why they are 6-0. I mean, I know that defensive line has gotten all the credit, but him and Fred Warner have been huge for that team. But yeah, that's just what I think. Those are my opinions. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and as always, thanks for watching.